Hi, this is Steve Michelotti of the Azure Government Engineering Team. I'm joined here today by Sarah Weldon, also of the Azure Government Engineering Team, and we're going to talk about the Azure Government Marketplace. So welcome, Sarah.
Thank you, Steve.
Okay, so what can we expect to talk about today?
Today, we're going to talk about Azure Government Marketplace. It is our publishing portal for allowing third-party publishers to make their software available in our Azure Government Cloud environment.
Okay. All right, so that's cool. So talk to me a little bit more about what is it and why do I care about it if I'm a cloud software developer?
Yeah, definitely. So Azure Government is our separate instance of Azure. It allows our government customers to be operating an entirely independent environment, yet still have all the benefits of using Azure's capabilities. So because of that, it is a separate publishing instance from Azure Commercial. But it is a great opportunity for publishers to reach the government space and make their offerings available and easy to reach from government customers.
And higher compliance levels and that sort of thing.
Yeah, yeah. So Azure Government has a very high compliance bar.
Okay.
And that's why the government customers like to come there. But the happy thing is that that's really what's available in our overall environment, and publishers can publish to the environment regardless of what their compliance stance is, because it's all hosted in the customer's subscription. They get some of that capabilities from the environment along with it.
Okay, excellent. All right, so this sounds like a great way to reach government customers. What if I'm someone that already has something in the commercial marketplace and I want to move this to Gov? How do I go about doing that?
That's a great question. So happily, the government is also served by the exact same publishing portal that our publishers use for commercial.
Okay.
So with just a couple of clicks, publishers can opt in to publish and make their solution available in Azure Government as long as it's supported in our environment.
Okay, this sounds great. Can you show us a little demo of some of these things that we've heard you talk about?
Sure, I'd be happy to. So as you can see here, this is the same publishing portal that our publishers use for commercial. All I need to do is go in, select new offer, and then as I'm going into the offer settings, I need to type in my offer ID.
So this offer ID is just some unique name sort of to give it?
Yeah, okay. It's a unique name. It has to fit the small type text.
Okay.
And then publisher ID is this is my publishing subscription.
Great.
And then the name, I also need to give it a unique name.
All right, pretty simple so far.
Pretty simple. And then I make sure I'm saving it along the way.
Okay, so as we're establishing the initial offer ID, publish ID, it's just kind of getting us an entry in the repository so we can have that basis for putting our marketplace entry in, is
yeah,
that correct?
Okay. Exactly. So each publisher will have their set of SKUs that are saved in here, and each time they publish, it'll move a version forward, or you might be setting it as a new naming convention as well.
Okay. So this is a SKU ID. I can specify whatever I want here.
Yep.
Okay.
Exactly. So it's just providing more information.
Okay. And this is just summary information, title summary.
Yep.
This is going to be displayed to my potential users.
Yes.
On the marketplace.
Yeah. The summary and description is all stuff that becomes more visible to
gotcha.
The user.
So we're putting quick stuff in here, but for a real app, we'd put nice thought out descriptions and all
yep.
that kind of stuff. This demo purposes. Okay, great.
And then we have it set as a solution template. There are other offerings in here that you can also select in as well, but solution templates are what we support in Gov. And as you can see here, there is the radio button that essentially lets you publish into the Azure Government environment. This is where you want to select in. And I'll also note, while most publishers like to have the same offering available in commercial and in Gov, if you have a case where you want to make changes specifically for your government customers, that is possible.
Okay.
So you can create a unique SKU that goes to the government space only and doesn't go to public Azure. You just select out of Azure.
Okay, great.
But for the most cases, publishers do both. One area where we get a lot of questions is about certifications, because there is a text dialog box in here where publishers can add certifications. This is entirely optional, but if you want to note things that your software has already gotten compliance certifications for, we wanted to make sure that we supported publishers being able to add that information
into here. What kind of certifications will we be talking about there?
It could be FIPS,
okay.
For example, on network compliances, compliance offerings. But for the most case, I think a lot of the publishers publishers like also leave this out.
Okay.
And then for package details, this is where you upload your actual file that supports the solution template. So it would be your JSON file as well as your UX definition.
Okay, great.
And then I've prepared one in here already. It also has to be a zip file, but okay. Publishers will be familiar with that as well.
I see there's a version number and that kind
yep.
of thing.
All right. So the version's always got to be numerical. Then you just enter that in, and I'll hit save again. And you can see here that I can now publish to the Azure Government environment.
Okay.
It's saving right now. And yet, if I hit publish, I'll get some flags. So you okay. do have to make sure that you go through all of the steps to fill out all of the information. There's a lot of content in here.
Okay. But it's pretty simple, straightforward stuff.
It's still simple stuff. Yeah. And I think for the most part, as publishers, if they're already publishing to the government space, a lot of this content will be already be created in their system.
OK, great. All right, so we'll just put some demo stuff in
yep.
now, test, and just kind of walk through the process so we show people
yep.
you know, what it is. All right. What's that marketing identifier? This is another like unique identifier for my organization?
So this is actually what shows up in the URL when you have the offering okay. open. Cool. So it's just what shows up in the domain. I think I actually can't have spaces because of that.
All right. But it'll give you little helps along the way if you're putting in
yeah,
something wrong.
It does. Okay. It does. And here is an important thing. So publishers that want to be able to test their offering in the environment before pushing it all the way to prod, you can enter your subscription ID for your subscription into this space, and then it essentially whitelists that subscription so that when you log into the portal, only you can see the offering that
okay.
you just published.
Great.
And in the government's case, you would want to get a trial or test subscription for Azure Government and put that subscription ID in here, because if you use a commercial subscription and you log into the government portal, you won't see your
That's
offering.
That's a mismatch.
Yeah, yeah you okay. won't see your offering. So you do want to make sure that your government subscription is the one that shows here.
Okay, great.
And then a couple of other basics. You just want to click into the categories you have. And then and here you need to upload the pictures that are essentially your logos.
All right, so I've got someone from my art department ready with the PNG files since
yep.
I'm a developer and have no concept of how to make anything look good. Okay, great. We're just going to select some icons here.
Yep, and they all have to meet the pixel requirements. But
And there's documentation on what the pixels need to be, that sort of thing.
Yep, okay. It's all flagged right there too. Great.
Okay, great. So I see last, almost done. We just have to put a little URL in for legal, and we'll just put some text in there for terms of use, and we're
yep.
good to go.
Great.
All right, so we just save that, and we're moving on.
We are. And here's just the support information that you need to be able to enter so that when customers have questions or need to log a support ticket, they have a contact.
Okay, great. So just basic contact information my organization's already established.
Yep.
Okay, so this essentially completes the process of creating my
yes.
marketplace item. We literally walked through it from start to finish in the span of 5 or 10 minutes. Okay, so now what?
Now we can hit publish.
Okay. It's got the email in there. We say yes. So how do I know, if I'm someone that's walking through this whole process, how do I know what to do? Is there documentation I can look at, or how do I do that?
Azure has common documentation for any publisher that's publishing to Azure for the very first time.
Okay.
And here is our documentation for steps for publishing. As I said, it is the same steps as commercial, but we put in here, you know, answers to some frequently asked questions like compliance considerations. As I said, you don't have to have specific compliance requirements for your solution before you're allowed to publish to Azure Government. We let customers make judgments on that, but we do make sure that you can put any compliance information you do have in there. And then you have the specific steps for publishing. One thing that does come up is being able to test your solution specifically in the government environment. And as I said, you need a government subscription in order to be able to do that. Publishers can acquire subscriptions to the government environment by applying for a trial account, which can then be converted to WebDirect or EA or whatever they prefer. But for acquiring your trial account, you do need to pass certain eligibility checks. We made it very straightforward for publishers to be able to do this. So it only takes a few days. And to do that, you can just come to our documentation site and get started by clicking with just a few clicks.
So what if I'm in a situation where I don't have any customers yet, but I want to get access? Does it let me do that?
Yeah. So for applying for access, once you've applied through our trial form that's on the website, one thing that you want to pay attention to is what you're selecting for your organization. If you're a solution provider that provides, they'll be publishing your offering to Marketplace, the best fit for you is actually the second bullet here, a solution provider that's serving U.S. federal state government entities. As part of that, really what you need to do is just show that you're registered with SAM's ID and DUNS number. It's basically a government database that allows them to take basic information about a company and just make sure that they have a record of them. Okay. So it basically shows that you have intent of doing business with the government. You don't have to prove that you have existing government customers, because otherwise you'd have a chicken and egg problem
where you
had to be registered, but you didn't have customers yet.
Absolutely.
Until you get registered. So just by filling this out, as long as you have, for your company, you have a U.S.-based address through one of your offices, it doesn't have to be all of them, but you have to have a U.S.-based office, then you shouldn't have any problems with registering for SAM.
Okay. All right, cool. All right, I heard you mention certifications earlier. So do I need to get, like, for example, FedRAMP first, or do I need to worry about things like having U.S. citizens perform in support roles? What do I need to think about there?
It's good questions. You don't have to have any of those in place in order to publish to Azure Government.
Okay.
It will mostly shape how customers choose to use your offering. So it may affect adoption in certain segments. For example, like DoD, they're going to have a pretty high compliance bar. But the other thing to consider is if they're deploying your solution in their own subscription, you might not need those exact compliance requirements, and it's better to let the customer make that judgment.
Okay, so this all sounds great. We've covered a ton of information. Just to close this out, any final tips or where we can go for more information if I'm someone that's interested in making sure that my solution works for Azure Government Marketplace?
Yeah, definitely. So we do have a number of pages for documentation that that partners can go to. We also have a really active community in Azure Government in Washington, D.C., as well as on our blog page. So definitely get integrated into our community by joining the blog site as well as potentially the meetup. And that lets you even get more integrated into the way government customers are starting to think so that you can make your solution be really successful with our customer base.
Okay, great. Well, thank you for joining us here today, Sarah, and sharing your knowledge. This has been Steve Michelotti with Sarah Weldon from the Azure Government Engineering Team. Thanks for joining us.